The landscape is changing. What started about 22 years ago with the release of WordPress, merging the capabilities of no-code and code, transitioned fast into what we know as the no-code environment, where tools like Framer, Squarespace, Wiz, Bubble, Flutterflow, and Webflow launch and allow people with no technical abilities to be able to create websites and launch them. And even furthermore, they allow for anybody to be able to go drag and drop some elements and release their own mobile apps, web apps, software as a service, and more. But now we have taken this a step further and we have been able to get the advantage of AI. AI allows you to create almost anything from scratch. Just by providing prompts in plain English, you're able to create websites, mobile applications, Google Chrome extensions, more in a matter of minutes. And we're going to be talking about one of the biggest updates that we have seen today, and that is Replit Agents 3. Replit Agents version 3 just came out a few days ago, and it's incredible what it can do for you. We're going to go over what it does well, what it could use some improvements on, and more importantly, how you can use it to launch your own business and be able to make money starting today. Stay tuned, because I will give you the full blueprint on how I will go about creating my own business using Replit version 3. But while you're here, please take a moment and like this video and subscribe to the channel. I release videos just like this one every single week, showcasing the best tools in the market that can help you take your business from where you are to where you want to be in a matter of months. Some instances, some people have been saying even weeks. Who knows? Maybe you can be next. Before we jump in, let's talk about what makes Agent 3 a potential game changer. And it all comes down to two really powerful features that are not only exclusive to Agent 3, but that solve real pain points on regular AI coding tool users just like you and me. For one, is automated self-testing. One of the biggest pain points by far, anyone building projects in tools like Cursor, Lovable, V0, Bolt, and others is the contents, bugs, and errors that you find in the builds. You see, every time the AI has to fix an error, you get charged for it. And it becomes time-consuming and really expensive. Agent 3 solved this. The way Agent 3 is solving this is by actually spinning up a virtual browser. It clicks through the app like a real user would do, and it finds their own errors and then go back and fix them all in a continuous loop until it got everything fixed. It's just like having a junior QA engineer built into the agent to help you identify and fix these bugs relatively early so you don't waste your time and money on that. The second feature Agent 3 introduces is the increase in the duration of the period of which it can work at a time, and it can massively increase in autonomy. They have gone from what they said was about 20 minutes building autonomously, over 200 minutes of unsupervised runtime. And the significance of this massive increase in autonomy is that now you can come up with an idea, craft a relatively detailed prompt, and forget about it until it's done. The agents break it down and accomplish each task that it comes up with. And we will jump into that here in a moment. But if you want the bottom line up front is that now you can ask the agent to actually build your whole project in one prompt, and it can go back and do it for you while you enjoy life. All right, to activate both of these features is relatively easy. And all you have to do is, if you are on brand new installation, or whether you are working on an old project, all you have to do is you want to create a brand new chat for the conversation that you're about to start using Agent 3, and it tells you up here what the requirement is, start a new agent. And all you have to do is you come down here to the agent tools, this feature that is down here, you're going to click on it. And to activate the app testing, all you have to do is toggle this on. And to activate the autonomy, all you have to do is toggle it on. All of these will be turned off. What you want to do is toggle it back on. And it is that easy to be able to get access to both of these tools. You also have access to other older features that are less known in Replit Agents, like web search, image generation, and lastly, high powered model, which I typically use for those tasks that are no-fail tasks, like the one that I'm creating in this other project that I'm about to show you. Now, this is a project that I have been working on for about an hour now. It has consumed a lot of credits because I am building an API for this CRM that I have built for my own projects and my own tools and my own business. And basically what it's doing right now is it's building an API so I can export data or input data using an API key via Zapier or direct third-party integrations. So basically, while it has been working for 1 hour, I have to prompt it to continue, even though it's on the continuous build, just because I have set up usage credit alerts and usage credits. So here's the alert, it's $15. And I have also used usage budget, which prevented to go over $30. I have removed that because I need this feature to be built. And so far I have actually used $31.11 on top of the $25 that I get every month. I'm fine with it as long as we build this feature. Now going back to it, another thing that I want to show you is that I provided a relatively, I would say, medium-sized prompt where it is a little descriptive, but I still left them vague for the AI to figure some things out and add its own touches to it. So it's creating the API. I provided and explained some of the endpoints that I need, but I also left it kind of wide open for the AI to determine exactly what it wants to build. And it started planning, it created the APA management system, it did all of these. As you can see, you can pause this video and take a look at what it did. But the most important thing that I want you to consider is that it actually created a task list that is going down one by one. And even though I had to prompt it to continue because of the whole budget, I didn't want it to go broke, you know, but this time I'm going all out because I need this done and I need it done yesterday. So here is actually working. But if we go up here, we can see every single task that it creates and what it's doing and how it's working on each individual task and what is the status of them. You can also see what is the thinking process behind everything that it's doing and everything that it planned. So it allows you to actually assess whether or not it's going in the right direction, and you can come here and suggest changes or require changes depending on the approach that you want to take. For us, we want to give it maximum flexibility and ensure that the AI can be actually what we want to build. So we're going to let it work until it's done. So it's probably going to take a long time. I'm actually about to go jump work out and come back and see our work stand here in about an hour or two. But the idea of this is that it can work about 3 hours and 20 minutes continuously without giving you any issues, without stopping and actually figuring out exactly what you need to do. And 3 hours and 20 minutes, if you stop, just say continue and it continues. Now, while this is a great advancement in technology, in reality, it's a big push that AI had been able to take. It doesn't mean anything if you cannot make money out of it, because at the end of the day, you need to pay your bills and put food on the table. And that's where these four ideas come in. Number one, the way I will make money with Agent version 3 is by selling internal tools and websites and perhaps some platforms and software to local businesses, while you, me, and a handful of us live in this AI bubble where we can see the advancement of AI and how it progresses, and we can make the most out of these tools. Not everybody is living in this bubble. Some local businesses doesn't even know how to make the most out of AI, and that's where you, me, and all of us come in. We can build websites, platforms, software, and even better, we can expand the horizons of what is possible to them by building it in just a matter of hours, if not minutes. You see, these local businesses are used to thinking that it's not possible for them to get the exact software that they want, so they recurred to just pay for what is available or just do it the old way, pen and paper, right? But you can develop the exact software that they need in order for them to be able to take their business to the next level. You can charge them a recurring fee, or you can charge them one-time fee with some recurring fee for hosting and to keep you a retainer. It's up to you what you would like to do. The way I will do it is the second course of action. I sell them the business outright and then charge them for hosting and charge them for a retainer fee to make sure that the tool runs. Relatively easy money. The second way that you can build businesses and make money is by building your own platform, whether that is a software as a service or any other kind of software out there that you can sell to people and you make money out of whatever the AI builds for you. You see, there are many needs out there for different type of software. People are looking for a certain CRM with certain features, or perhaps it's a landing page builder, or perhaps it's an emailing tool. Regardless of the idea that you have, there is probably people out there wanting it. Now, I'm not going to say that every idea is a good idea, but reality is that so long as you do your due diligence and you come up with a good idea, Replit Agents version 3 is able to build it for you. Their idea that I have for today is building and flipping websites. Yep. All way that you build a website, you rank it on Google, or in this case, in ChatGPT and other LLMs, and then flip it for a profit. You can build this website using best practices using Replit Agents version 3, and after ready in a matter of hours, develop a content plan, upload the content, then rank it, and then sell them. If you sell enough of these, you can be making 5 to 6 figure income in a matter of time. Now, I'm not saying it's easy, but it's completely doable. Now, the last idea might sound cliche, I don't know, but it's an idea that I have used time and time again to generate income for myself, and that is building templates. You see, there's many people out there that they want to test these AI coding tools, but they don't know how to prompt it, or they're not getting the results that they want and need in order for them to be able to continue. That's where templates come in. Templates is a starting point that allow them to go rather from 0 to 100, from 50 to 100, and allow them to build on a solid base. You see, you don't have to provide a 100% solution. You can provide a 50% solution that will get them there. Whether that is already having a design system set up or having payments and other APIs set up, among other things, you can do this and sell them to people that are looking for these kind of solutions. You can charge between $100 and $1,000. And depending on the niche that you go for, you can sell quite a few of these every single month. Best part is that you don't have to sell one type of template. You can develop templates every single month so you can continue growing your portfolio, and the opportunities for you to sell more and more every month continue to grow as you add more templates to your portfolio. And with this, we have reached the end of yet another video. Since you're here until the end, I'm going to assume that you liked this video. If you did, please consider liking this video and subscribing to the channel. Every single week, I release videos just like this one, showcasing the best AI tools out there, from AI coding to AI video, AI images, and more. I am showcasing what is the best out there that there is to offer for you to be able to use it and make money in your own business, in your own hustle. With that, thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.